And now to talk about content marketing in the context of the airline industry, which we all know is pretty cutthroat for its pricing, but is content a way to look beyond that? We've got Chantal von Weinbergen from Jetstar. Chantal.
They've asked me to talk about content beyond price wars, which is easy because it's easier to create nice content which is not about price, and it's harder to create content which is fun to watch, which is about price. But happy to share with you some things what we have been doing the last 12 months and our learnings. And I just keep it light. I know it's almost end of the day, but I hope you, of course, have seen it. If not, I hope to spark some emotion with you. So the airline category in Singapore is tough. Competition is fierce. Our initial field is, of course, the budget airline. So it's AirAsia, Scoot. We had Tiger. Now it's Scoot alone and us. But the moment our competitors drop their price, when I talk about full service carriers, then your choice becomes even more. So why would you then choose a budget airline if you just pay a bit more? And then if you think about budget airlines themselves and how we communicate, it's a lot about price, and it's all the same. And if it's not about price, it's about destination. Rashid earlier today shared some great destination pieces Silk has done. And we all do those pieces, and we have to do it because we have to sell the destination, but at the same time is we inspire you to travel somewhere, but at the end, you will for sure check all the price on all the websites, and then you make your choice. So it's not really about the brand, which is kind of like a challenge. So it's all same, but different. And the only thing which differentiates ourselves is a personality. So how do you stand out in the crowd? And how do we connect with our customers without interrupting them to build some brand love? How we do that is we create stories which bring our brand purpose of empowering travelers to have their travels to life. So how do we do that? Well, first thing is we try to flip things on its head. We are 13 years old, coming 13 years old. So is our fleet. We call it a matured fleet. Whereas competitors have new shiny aircraft, they have new tools, they have new flatbeds, and they have new in-flight entertainment. So what do we have? We have a captive audience for a few hours, but we didn't have any of those new shiny things. But what we knew was that our customers, half of them, like to read on our airplane and spend time with a book. And somehow last year, it became very actual when the government was working on its inaugural National Reading Day. So that for us was a 1 + 1 = 2. And we thought about the sharing economy as well. And how could we tap into that? Launched a new kind of like in-flight entertainment. The very first world's flying book exchange. So we tied up together with the National Reading Board and we launched it together with them. So we were lucky to ride on the wave of PR coming together with that. And on the inaugural National Reading Day, we shared in that same week we shared almost 1,000 books with our customers to further help spread the joy of reading. And we encourage people to leave their books on board. So we, on the flight, we distributed stickers and we asked people if they had, if they came back from their holidays and they had finished their book, if they could leave it on board, put a sticker in there, so we could share it with other customers coming on board, which is great. So it was not only a matter of engaging with our own customers, but the idea traveled so much that a lot of people on Facebook really loved the idea of reigniting the love for reading and sharing books. And that that traveled further with some nice PR pickup. And the most important thing is, although we didn't have really something tangible new, we were able to increase our net promoter score for that month with +26% versus the previous month, and even with 51% versus the previous year. So it's a little thing, but it's it really had good traction with our customers. So when you think about content, look at what you have or what you maybe not have and flip things on its head. Then the second thing is create new news. If you don't have anything new to tell, you might create something which might lead to some new news. So the budget airlines do a great world in opening up the world to us. And they're such a great place to be to live in Singapore because most fabulous destinations are just 2 or 3 hours away. But the problem is that we have a limited number of leave days, and often we like to tie them back with our public holidays. But then the problem is when you start tying it back to public holidays, often it involves a lot of planning, and then time passes by and the demand goes up, which means our prices go up, and you feel frustrated because you have to think that we're out there to cheat you, which is not the case, but it's just how our model works. So how could we flip that on its head and change that perception? Because we know, in essence, there are kind of like two types of travelers. So one are the people who really plan far ahead, and it takes a lot of time, and then they are just too late to book. Or there are people who just don't think about it until it's a few weeks in advance, and they would like to travel, but then the prices have gone up. So how can we change that perception around the prices of the long weekends? So we've introduced the 2017 long weekend flight package. So we tied up all the 7 weekends 2017 had. We determined which destination would go in what weekend, and it was perfect in terms of like rainy season. So it was all in the good seasons. There were no hidden features. It was really 7 return flights to 7 perfect destinations across 7 long weekends. So no debate about where you would go. It was all settled. And the good thing for us, it was a great price point. It was very competitive. It sparked a lot of conversation. And it created that sense of urgency because it was only limited package availability, which taps into the Singaporean Kia Zoo. So we had everything planned out. And we did some research with our customers. And it appeared that there are kind of like 4 types of travelers. And they are in the right-hand corner. So there's the commitment folk, the over-researcher, the bargain hunters, and the last-minute guy. And to bring that to life, we interviewed some of our customers, and we put it together into a video to promote the package.
Trying to book for a long weekend, but the tickets are just too expensive.
We might face the challenge where there might be no flights.
Because everyone wants to go during that period, it's harder to get flights.
Just by looking at the flights, there's so many options.
A lot can change in a month, so you don't know if you will be able to leave that morning early from work. If we don't book instantly, it doesn't happen.
Yeah. Bangkok. We're supposed to go next weekend.
Yeah.
Didn't happen.
Yeah. One person booked their flight and the rest of us did not.
I think we've missed flights or deals before, hoping that it would be a better deal
later on.
He's the type that he would say, hey, can we like plan maybe this month, can we go this place?
Sam is definitely an over-researcher.
Everything's just giving cool. Us many options.
Sometimes I only need help a bit, but he doesn't help me.
I let the lady do the bookings and everything.
Yeah. For the whole year?
Every long weekend planned out, it actually would be much easier.
It would. That's taking advanced planning to the next level.
we used this video to push it out 1 week, 1 week before the SIL actually went live to spark a conversation. And our fans were quick to share it because everyone recognized themselves or their partners or their friends with one of the four types. And having the research around it, it sparked a conversation with the media outlets in Singapore as well. So the good thing is that even Class 95 picked it up, and they we couldn't brief it more perfectly than they did completely for free. Oh, could you click on the? Could you click on the? Yes.
At about 8:49 with your muttons in the morning, Justin and Vernon driving you to work. Here's something very interesting I read that Jetstar is doing.
Jetstar, okay.
Yeah. So next year, 2017, mm-hmm. is going to have 7 long weekends.
Right. Not too bad.
Very good, actually. Yeah. Now, if you think about it, mm-hmm. We all would love to travel on long weekends.
Why not?
Right? Take a short holiday to a regional country. You can even go as far as Australia for a long weekend. Mm. Stuff like that. What is the biggest, most annoying thing about trying to get air tickets for long weekends?
This thing goes on for 3 minutes. And literally, expensive. They are debating the mechanic, sometimes, the destinations, if it's worthwhile, yes or no. It's crazy, but it's awesome that it sparked even a conversation on Class 95. So the video was live for 1 week, and we got 425,000 views and 44,000 engagements. And the video had a 73% completion rate. So there was something in the video which people kept on looking at. 31 pieces of content, and then most important is that we saw in that particular week the site visits go up with 9%, and we saw the specific landing page promoting this package had 55,000 visitors in just 1 week, which is fantastic. On the day the package went live, it was sold out in 10 minutes. So there is for sure appetite for it. So we're looking into how, if and how we should recreate this. But the good thing is that it's not even that we sold out the packages, but we saw relatively for all those long weekends, we saw an increase in the uptake compared to the year before. So we not only changed the perception of travel around long weekends, but we actually changed the behavior itself as well. So create new news. Then the third thing is humanize products. We have a lot of products, and people are not aware of those products, or a lot of things are very tactical, very dry, and we often don't talk about it. So have a look if you can humanize those products. Thing was, for Chinese New Year, we had done some things the past few years, so it was kind of like normal that we would do Chinese New Year. And because it's such an important moment in the year. And we were looking into how can we create an emotional connection beyond the sale, because everyone's going on sale around that time. And it's such an important travel period as well, because a lot of people travel to go back to their families to have the reunion dinner together. But there was a flip side as well. We saw 2016 versus 2015 that 10 to 20% more people were traveling just for leisure, not to spend time with their families with reunion dinner, but just spend time with their own family. So it means that they deprioritized reunion dinner. And that is where we decided to take a stand.
Really?
Yes, really.
I mean, this is not a prank.
For sure.
Will you?
Definitely.
When is the
ticket? Oh, what?
I totally take it.
I'll have to check with my family.
I wouldn't go. Because if I were to go, family is apart. And it's weird to do that during CNY.
我的家婆就不能够接受，因为我在家里是主角哎，对，主婆的主角，连有一次过年的时候好像没有跟我们在一起，所以有一点伤感呐，就是说在国外你要亲手给他们红包啊，要听他们的一些祝福语啊，你就会做少了一个孩子在身边，尤其是跟着爷爷奶奶，他们跟爷爷奶奶很亲，都会亲他。
Me and my daughter Sabrina, you know, we would like, you know, we dressed up. Do we have this kind of like a so-called a ritual or a tradition? There was one year that she didn't have the Chinese New Year in Singapore. It's not the same, you know? My girl was missing.
I feel really touched that she's I would stay and be with my family.
有两次她出国，我会感觉到家里少了一个宝贝女儿，她不在的话，又感觉会少了一些东西这样子。
Thank you for offering that, but we will also still have to decline. Travels can be anytime with family, but I think every once a year is where we meet people that we don't get to see often.
跟你讲的话感动一下嘞。<laughs>
Thank you for giving up free flight tickets to spend time with family during Lunar New Year.
捷信航空在这里要赠送您 888的礼券, 让你全家能在新的一年一起出国度假.
Because you can travel anytime, stay home this Lunar New Year. Wow, it's nice!
你要不要出国?
我不想出国。
So, at the start of the new Lunar New Year, we basically ask people to stay home, which is pretty interesting for an airline who kind of like always asks you to travel around. This was a social experiment, and we were pretty excited. We have never done a social experiment like this before, and we didn't know what the outtake would be, but we're pretty happy with how it all played out. And we had lots of coverage across the key media channels in Singapore and the region. The video had 1.2 million views in 2 weeks, and more than 57,000 engagements. And the landing page visits were 30,000. And at the end, 40 people have asked for a flight change request. So normally we have the product always available. You just have to pay for it. So it was a nice way for us to flip it around again and to create some new news about the product and make that emotional connection with our customers. And the thing was, when we showed the video before we launched it internally, there were a few people who said, like, this is wrong. We're a commercial company. How come we are actually asking people to stay at home? But luckily, most people embraced the video, and they shared it with their friends. And at the end, the video created a lot of internal proud to be working at Jetstar. This is one which I put in, make push messages fun. I started by saying it's much more difficult to create content around prices rather than creating content around who you are or what you sell. But this week, we went live with a Price Be Guarantee campaign. And what is it? So our competitors are not only airlines. With the arrival of online travel agents like Expedia, Traveloka, and many more of them, we're kind of like frenemies. It's great because they are another channel where we can sell our flights. At the same time, they own the customer, whereas we'd rather have them convert on our website because then we can upsell, we can communicate with them in case there's any disruption in their travel plans. So it's kind of like a relationship we have, which is maybe sometimes a little bit awkward. And we have this thing called the Price Guarantee for a few years now, and we have widened it up to include the websites, not only of competitors, but also to include it of the online travel agents. And what it means is if you find a comparable flight on any of those sites, which is cheaper than ours, then we will beat that fare with 10%. Very dry message, a bit complicated, but it's a great proof point for our all-day, everyday, low-fare proposition. So how can you make that more fun? So we launched the Beat the Price game this week. We have introduced Jetta, which is the mascot of Jetstar Japan. And in Japan, it's very common to have mascots. And it works pretty well in the game. So if you go to lowestfares.jetstar.com, you can play the old school arcade game, Whack the Mole, but then you can whack the prizes, and you can win prizes depending on your high score. And we have it in a in 5 bus shelters across the island as well. And this is what happened this week. Which is great. It's a different kind of content, but it really works well. So, just to wrap it up, flip things on its head, create new news, humanize products, and make push messages fun. And then it all comes together if you base it on insights, and you tie it back to the purpose of your organization. That's it. Oh, the last one. It all looks so simple when you look at it. It keeps on. You need to keep on practicing. You have some good ones, you have some bad ones, but don't forget to have fun along the way. You'll get there somehow. Someday it will be there. Thank you.